क्लास 9, लेट अस राइट डाउन द क्वेश्चन फॉर डायरी एंट्री. ओके, दैट यू हैव टू राइट डाउन इन योर फेयर नोटबुक्स. एंड एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट इमीडिएट आफ्टर द फॉर्मेट ऑफ डायरी एंट्री यू हैव टू राइट डाउन अ डायरी एंट्री, राइट? राइट अ डायरी एंट्री expressing your feelings when you write or when you made a diary entry for the first time and also mention why you started writing. Okay, so it means that for the very first time when you have written a diary entry, okay, for that you have to write it down in your diary entry, means why you have started writing down. Okay, what were your feelings when you expressed yourself in diary? Okay, right? So you have to write it down. Okay, rest otherwise, so you know that there are different type of questions like that, for example, how you felt when you get prize, like all that. Okay, so how I celebrated my birthday. So these are the other things. Okay, so little bit of, you can say, speculative type, that you have to think it over, that why I should write down a diary and why I started writing a diary. Okay, so note down this question, please. Okay, written question. Dear, what are you saying? Okay, fine. Question is written, no? Now next, after that we are going to start with the chapter bond of love. Bond of love, beehives, next chapter. A bond of love, bond of love, where this bond existed. You know, love is a kind of feeling in which a person, you can say, person will selflessly admire somebody else. Okay, love also includes respect, okay, for someone else. This respect can be of somebody's feelings, or this respect can be of somebody's qualities. And moreover, when this love existed between a human being and an animal, so this also involves kindness, right? So you know that, and many of you must be having pets in your house. How much you people are attached to them? Very much. Okay, there you can say small acts, sometimes they drive you crazy, sometimes you feel more attracted towards them, sometimes you feel to spend some time when you are feeling bored also, or when you are feeling that nobody is there in this world with me, I can spend some time with my pet. Okay, so it is like when you have a pet in your home, it is your deliberate desire that I should have one pet in my home. Okay, so but sometimes some accidentally when you get a pet, then what happens? And when you take care of that pet, naturally the pet will become a family member. Okay, you feel like it's really very difficult to survive or to live without this pet, because ultimately what happened, this pet sooner or later become a part of your life. Okay, so as they have turned out to be part of your life, so at that moment you feel that our life is incomplete without them, or our life is not complete without these pets. Okay, so here in this chapter we are going to study about a family, okay, in which the narrator, who has accidentally got a pet, okay, because he has gone to my soul. Okay, so where he has seen in the sugarcane fields, some of the people, they were hunting or they were driving wild pigs out of their fields, farmers. And his friend, he was also shooting. Okay, then what happened? Accidentally, that bullet, it hit one of the, you can say, one of the bear. Okay, so you know, bear is not a small animal. It was a baby bear. The narrator, out of only kindness and out of the need that this animal needs some care, he has brought it to his house to, and he has presented it to his wife. The wife, who was alone at home, she felt so much attached with this animal that this animal has turned out to be a very important part of her life. But when this bear, you know, it is really very difficult to take care of pets, isn't it? You, because they don't understand your language, first of all. Okay, like dogs, they understand some of the things. But the thing is that when you have a pet in your home, you have to change your lifestyle or your habits according to them also sometimes. And you need to, you can say, you need to understand their language also, what exactly they want. When it is time to take them a go, to take them out, when they need some, you can say, free space, okay? You, when they want food, you have to set a proper timetable for them also. So in this chapter also, narrator's wife, she has taken completely care of that animal and she got so attached. But naturally, when this bear was a small child, he was just, you can say, well, this can be carried in a lap only. Okay, he can be playing in the house. But soon you have seen when this animal is fully grown up, okay, how much height it gains, okay, about this much, and he is ferocious also, okay. You know, you must have seen that some of the people showing shows of, showing road shows of those bears. So you have seen that some cover is always being put over their mouths. Very sharp teeth they have, okay, and they are carnivorous also. They can attack any human being. And she was advised that he has grown up enough and it is not wise enough to keep this kind of animal at home. Finally, this bear, it has been sent to the zoo, okay, in Mysore zoo. But after that, both the animal as well as narrator's wife, they were not able to live without each other. She was also not eating anything, and moreover, the bear was also not eating anything. In the zoo, he was not living a happy life. He was not eating anything, sitting in one corner of the cage, and ultimately the wife finally decided to bring it back. So when it is brought back to the house, then a separate sort of island, okay, you can say highland, has been built, and there this bear, it was kept forever. So this means that there existed, we human beings, they need to be caring, they need to talk kindness towards all these animals, okay? And this is, you can say, very much necessary. And it means that love is a, there existed a bond between human beings as well as animals. So this chapter, we need to, we will come to know that how there existed this unseen bond between a human being as well as that of animal, right? So this is all about chapter bond of love. So bond of love, between whom it existed, bond, that bond between narrator's wife as well as the bear. Okay, it existed between them, right? So finally, coming back, beyond that day, you have given me the list. Huh? Who has made that list? Marks one. Who was sitting on front desk? Ramneek, you were there, na? List is with me, you have given me. So now, move on to your books, please. Bond of love. Can there be love and friendship between human beings and wild animals? Let's read a fascinating account of an orphaned sloth bear. Okay, so let me open up my book also. Yes. So There existed a fascinating account of an orphan sloth bear. Sloth bear is a special type of bear, okay, right, that can eat termites also. Okay, this is one of the quality of these bears, and that was rescued by the author. Okay, so as I told you that this is a story about what? This I have already told you that this story is about the sloth bear who was orphaned. Mother was killed in hunting, during hunting, and the bear was left all alone. Finally, the narrator, when he has seen that this bear needs care, this bear needs to be taken care of, then what happened? He has taken that bear to his home. Sloth bears, now there is a little bit of description about sloth bears. Please see. Sloth bears inhabit forested areas, including the tropical rainforests of India and grasslands at lower elevations. I mean, not at much greater heights. It has been found. Where it is mainly found? It is found in forested areas, tropical rainforests of India and grasslands at lower elevations, means not at much mountainous heights. Sloth bears have very shaggy hair. Shaggy means furry, curly, okay? And shaggy means not properly kept up. Dirty, otherwise it is said. Rough, right? Shaggy hair and long muzzles. Muzzle means that mouth and nose, it has been protruding. Okay, so you can see in the picture how his nose part, okay, it has been protruding, formulating a muzzle. This is called, they have long muzzles. Using their claws to dig, they can then use their lips to form a tube which can go deep into the ground or into the hard to reach areas like dead trees for their food. Yes, I told you that they also feed on termites. So how they feed on termites? Because termites, they are mainly find inside the trees, and it is always hidden because they what termites they feed upon? They always feed upon wood, okay, bark of tree. So what he used to found? Because when he gets a sign that there are some termites, so what it will do? It will ultimately formulate a tube like structure with its lips and try to suck them out. Okay, it is trying to suck those termites out of the tree with the help of his muzzle. Okay, so their main food is termites. See, main food is termites, and you can hear them suck up their food from several feet away. From several feet away, this, you can say, this sucking or this process of sucking, it can be found. Okay, right? So I will begin with Bruno. So what was the name of this bear? Bruno. Okay, the name of the bear was Bruno. Bruno, my wife's pet sloth bear. So whose pet it was? It was narrator's wife. And which category of bear it was? It was a sloth bear. What kind of bear it was? It was a sloth bear. I got him for her by accident. And how the narrator has got it? He told that he has got it just by accident. By accidentally he has got it 2 years ago. Now he has come to the story how he has got this. Yes, how he has found that bear. 2 years ago, we were passing through the sugarcane fields near Mysore. People were driving away the wild pigs from the fields by shooting at them. So 2 years ago, he has given an example that 2 years ago, when he was passing from where he was passing from sugarcane fields, yes, people were driving away the wild pigs. So what the people were doing? They were driving away the wild pigs from the fields by shooting at them. Okay, so otherwise it is quite inhuman and against the law also, right? Right, poaching is finally banned in India. Okay, but it was not that time when this law has been passed. It was before than that. Okay, in order to drive those wild pigs, because wild pigs, they are also very ferocious, great attackers. Okay, they can even kill a human being. So this is the reason why they were using these guns to drive them away from their sugarcane fields. So people were driving away the wild pigs from fields by shooting at them. So what they were doing? They were shooting at them Some were shot and some escaped. Naturally, when with this kind of shooting or hunting is going on, some will be at your target and some finally escaped. Escape means, yes, to be saved from being hit. Okay, they have been saved. We thought that everything was over when suddenly a black sloth bear came out panting in the hot sun. Panting means heavily breathing when someone is tired. Okay, so what happened? We thought that everything was over. They thought that now all the pigs, they have been driven away, or some of the pigs, they have been killed, they have been shot dead. But finally, what happened? A black sloth bear, it came out panting in the hot sun. Why it was panting? Because it was tired of running in the hot sun. Okay, so it was tired in that hot sun. Now I will not shoot a sloth bear wantonly. Wantonly means without, you can say, without any reason. Yes, very good. Wantonly, wanton desire means without any desire. And you know that when this hunting, this has been a tradition in India, okay, of hunting. Okay, kings, rajas, maharajas. So what they used to do? They go on hunting expeditions. So have you ever thought that what is the reason of hunting them? No. You may have seen in the old, you can say, kingdom palaces, the skin of the tiger, it adorned the palaces. Okay, it is also formulating the rugs. Okay, and all that. So what is the need of hunting those animals? No, there is no need. It was just our desire to enjoy a bit this kind of hunting. Recreational purpose it was, of course, right? So what it means that just because of this, what kind of desire it was? It was, of course, a wanton desire out of nothing. It has arose, okay? And out of nothing, we are feeling to these kind of animals. We feel that these animals will be killed because we want them. Okay, but finally, when a law has been passed, then this, you can say, these animals, they are also considered as, you can say, important as that of human beings, that they need not to be killed. Why they need not to be killed? Because of the reason they too are living creatures. And to live and let live, this policy should always be adopted by human beings. Then afterwards, this law has been enacted, as well as it has been implemented also, that no one will ever kill an animal. Okay. So he said, but I will not shoot a sloth bear wantonly, but unfortunately for the poor beast, one of my companions did not feel that way about it, and promptly shot the bear on the spot. He said, but what the narrator thought? The narrator thought that why I should kill that animal wantonly, means why I should kill that animal without any reason. Okay, so he thought that killing this kind of animal without any reason was of no use. Okay, so finally, right? So he thought that killing this kind of animal was of no use at all. Okay. So after that, he thought that, but one of his companions, he was not thinking in that manner. So what he was thinking, he thought that this animal should be killed because just out of his, you can say, crazy desire, just of his desire to hit it. Before the narrator would say, no, we would not do that. What happened? He hit that sloth bear. Okay, on the spot. Now, finally, what would be the next step? The two persons will run to come near the bear to see what has happened to that bear. So finally, as we watched the fallen animal, we were surprised to see that the black fur on its back moved and left the prostrate body. Prostrate means lying on the ground. Okay. So he said, when we watched that fallen animal, when they have gone there, they have seen that the animal has been fallen to the ground. Then what happened? That black fur on its back moved and left the prostrate body, something detached from the body which was lying onto the ground. What was that? That has been detached. Then we saw it was a baby bear that had been riding on its mother's back. And when the sudden shot had killed her, So what has happened? So then they have, when they have come closer, they have noticed that what it was a baby bear. Okay, who has been separated from the mother because the mother was dead and he was trying to save himself. Okay, and got, and has detached from the mother. The little creature ran around its prostrate parent, making a pitiful noise. So see the feeling. Means the child has come to know mother is dead. You know, these kind of animals, they have a very strong sense of smell. Okay, and by viewing only the actions, they can sensitize whether the person is alive or dead. Okay. So when the child see such a small child, when it has come to know that the mother is dead, he was moving, running around helplessly. Animals too have feelings. You must have seen, okay, when a small dog, it has been separated from the mother, how it cries. Okay, it is always looking for mother. Okay, and similarly cats also, you may have seen. How many of you have ever observed the cat's behavior? Okay, what you have observed? Yes. They are conscious and they attack with their claws also. Their claws are very sharp. Hai na? Aise hi hota hai na? Yes. Sounds they always produce. Nails, yes, claws, they have very sharp. They attack with that only. They never let their child to be touched. Okay. So similarly, when this child, it was separated from the mother and he has sensitized, he has felt that now the prostrate body is lying onto the ground and it was making a pitiful noise, different kind of noise, which evokes pity, which arouses the pity of the onlookers, and it has started moving here and there. I ran up to it to attempt a capture. Now narrator has ran in order to capture it, okay, but it's not so easy to capture. I scooted into the sugarcane field. Scooted means
ran away.
He was running because he was running after that deer in the sugarcane field. Following it with my companions, I was at last able to grab it by the scruff of its neck. Scruff means that thick skin, okay, which is covered with hair. Okay, what happened? Then finally, with the help of his companions, not a single person is able to catch them. Then finally, what has happened? Narrator caught hold of it from the neck and finally snapped and tried to scratch. And while it snapped, okay, while it snapped means it tried to make, yes, to separate and tried to scratch me with the long hooked claws. And what it was trying to scratch the narrator with the long hook claws. Because why it was doing so? Or you can say because there is never existed any kind of relation. This kind of child, he has never witnessed any kind of, you can say, human being near him. So for him, it was totally a stranger. As it was a stranger, what he wanted to drive them away in order to release himself from the strong grip of the narrator, because it was a human being. He thought that this person has killed my mother, or because he did not know who has killed his mother, but he knew that human beings are responsible for killing the mother, and ultimately he was not feeling at all safe. And animals, you know, they are never happy with human beings. They want to live in their own habitat, open, free. Okay, they enjoy their freedom. So finally, the narrator was able to catch hold of it. We put it in one of the gunny bags we had brought. And when I got back to Bangalore, I duly presented it to my wife. So finally, he was not carrying it, okay, because it was attacking with its claws, scratching the body of the narrator, okay. So they have put it in a gunny bag made up of jute. And finally, he has brought it back to Bangalore. And when he has come to his house, he has presented it to his wife. She was delighted. What expression you could expect? Being delightful, being happy and surprised. Okay. So she at once put it in put a colored ribbon around its neck, and after discovering the cub was a boy, she christened it Bruno. Christened means gave a name. What the name was given? She has given it the name as Bruno. So how she welcomed that young animal? By tying a ribbon around its neck. That was ultimately what it was delivering. It was delivering, yes, complete love, okay, for this animal. So finally, what happened that she has presented it to his wife and she has given it the name of Bruno. So let us have a short, you can say, questioning round. Yes, beta, stand up. Where did the narrator found sloth bear, young sloth bear? Mysore. Where in Mysore? Anywhere in Mysore? Yes, in sugarcane fields. Sit down, please. Next, why he has gone to those sugarcane fields? Why and what he has seen in sugarcane fields? Yes, when he has gone to sugarcane fields, what he has seen? Why the people have gone there? In order to drive away wild pigs. Okay, in order to drive away wild pigs from their fields. Okay. So sit down, please. How they were driving those wild pigs last? How they were driving away those wild pigs from their sugarcane fields? Yes? By shooting at them. Sit down. So finally, what strange or what you can say surprising experience was made by narrator? Yes, next, Pragun. His friend, he has... It was not accidentally, it was knowingly, deliberately he has done that. Yes, a sloth bear, it has got separated from its mother's body. Okay, so finally what happened? Then what happened when this... Yes, his friend, he tried to... Then finally the narrator, he tried to rescue that sloth bear. Okay, so when he has got the sloth bear, what did it... What did he do with that sloth bear? What did he do with the sloth bear? Yes. What did he do with sloth bear? Yes. Okay, Simon. Sit down, please. What did he do with sloth bear? Yes, he tried to catch hold of it and he has brought it to present it to his wife. Okay, he has brought it home in order to present it to his wife. So what kind of first expression was shown by narrator's wife, Jisru? Yes, she was very happy, she was delighted, she tied a ribbon. Very good. She tied a ribbon around its neck and ultimately what name was given to it as? Bruno. Okay, so Bruno was the name that was ultimately given to that of, you can say, bear. Sloth bear. Okay. So this is how the narrator has got this sloth bear. So naturally this bear soon it turned out to be a family member. So Bruno soon took to drinking milk. So see here, what important, what are the different things that the animal was eating? Bruno soon took to drinking milk from a bottle. It was but a step further, and within a very few days he started eating and drinking everything else. Starting now, what is the first thing in the starting to be given to animals? Milk. And with the help of a small bottle, right? And soon this animal was eating everything else, anything else he was eating, whatever is available in the house. Okay, and everything, what is the everything includes? He ate porridge like khichdi and dalia, okay, made from any ingredients, vegetables, fruits, nuts, meat, especially pork is pig's meat, yes, and curry, rice, regardless of condiments and chilies, without including these, okay, spices, yes. Bread, eggs, chocolate, sweets, pudding, ice cream, etc., etc. As for drink milk and for drink what he's drinking? Milk, tea, coffee, lime, juice, aerated water, and anything liquid water or anything which is available at home. And it all went down with relish. Relish means he was enjoying all these things. So this is how the bear was completely enjoying its, you can say, stay at the family. And it was loved a lot. It was being cared, it was, you can say, of course, taken care of a lot. And after this, what has happened? It has turned out to be completely a family member. Okay, so this is how you can say the story further went on, and we will continue it further.